Alright, we're almost ready to go on our camping trip here. We're going to go on an overnight ride. Got my stuff ready here. And I got to show you Mr. Ed back here. His cool device he's got going on. Got his top, got all his stuff on there. Hopefully it doesn't hit his head when he gets in there, and should be all right. He's got it all on there.
There's chair, tent, sleeping bag, food. I got enough food for a week, I think.
Yeah. Enough food for a week. Yeah. Yeah, and I even brought hot dogs, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, we got hot dogs and some sausage for tomorrow. It'll be pretty good. See you on the road a little bit.
This is Paul. We're getting outfit. We're getting ready to roll. Ready. We're going to, where are we going, Paul?
Panther Creek State Park.
Do
some bike packing, man.
Trike packing. Paul's got it all ready. Well, I don't know. We're going to give this a try. This is really the first time I've had everything on there. So I'm going to repack when we get there. Spread stuff out. I think in that bag is about 10 pounds, I'm going to guess. Maybe 8 to 10 pounds in the bag. Sleeping gear, stuff, and a chair on top. Rain gear. Got food and clothes, tools and stuff. Camera gear, tripod, got a tripod. Anyway, we're looking real dangerous this morning. That is for sure. Well, here we go. We're on the road. This is the first time I've been trike camping, so it'll be an experience for me. I've got some gear ordered that's going to be lighter than what I've got now. I pretty much have a mix of new stuff and some just regular camping gear that's heavier, bulkier. We are leaving Dandridge, heading for Panther Creek State Park. Paul's rig.
We just
finished climbing a little hill.
Climbing these hills are just killer, man.
We're ready to go home.
Yeah, ready to leave.
We're on our first downhill. We've been riding for about a mile, I think. All uphill from Paul's place. So it's real pretty up through here. And nice and cool. Paul's checked out. I told him I was gonna take it a little slow. Check on my cargo. Seem to be doing okay. I think if I hit a rough bump it might flex down and land on the top of my helmet for just a moment. Thus far I haven't done it. Pretty day. We've got two really beautiful days to ride. So glad we're doing it. Cherry back there. Yeah, we're still going. God, it's hot out here. Can't see the temp. Trust me. Oh, we're rolling. Up to about 30 back here.
We got out a little further instead of Miller Road.
When we first started
riding, we took this road, and it used to be really, really bumpy. It had holes in it, potholes.
Well, this is nice
and
back here.
It's beautiful, yeah.
Oh, it's wonderful. Now, how many times have you been on this?
This is the first time since they repaved it.
Well, how'd you know it was paved?
Last time me and Gene came, we went past it. And I said to Gene, I said, oh, man, they paved this road.
Oh, okay. So this is the first time you've been on this road since it's been paved.
First time I've been on here, yep.
Now, let's just go through this little tiny town up here. This is beautiful. It's nice and cool. This paving is just satin smooth so far. It's real nice. This is what my load looks like. It's the one thing I've noticed, I've got so much weight back there up high that on that 700 rear tire going down a hill at 30 miles an hour, there's some tail wave that goes on, so I had to brake it. That didn't feel good at all. So anyway, I've got to do some load shifting. And that was one of the things Paul and I discussed when we get up here. I'll spend some time repacking and shuffling stuff around. This is really the first time I've had all this on there. I probably have got close to 10 pounds, maybe 12 on that roof, or parts of the roof. A little early in the leaf season, and we're not really expecting to have a pretty year. Last month was the driest recorded September in history since they've been keeping records here in Tennessee. I think it was 1870s. We didn't even have a quarter of an inch of rain, I don't think, all month. So they're expecting the leaves just to brown out and fall. So it's a beautiful day. Another hill. I'll see if I can hang on here for a moment. Here. There we go. We've just been taking it pretty easy on these hills. Going up. We're both overweight. I've got canned goods back there. I didn't know Paul was bringing hot dogs and stuff. This is the first time he and I have been out trike packing. So we'll learn what each of us will have. Paul, did you bring your hammock?
Yeah.
So did I. It's a pretty little section of road here. We'll begin to see just a hint of leaf change, but it seems like it's not vivid, for sure. Well, this is TrikePacking. Oh boy. Paul's just gonna do me in today, I can tell right now. Dumping Valley Road.
Yeah, well, we're doing it. I think we got about 5 miles in right now. Dead up there. He's beating me today. for a little bit. Got a beautiful day for riding. Beautiful day for going camping too, man. Gonna do some camping up here pretty soon. In a little bit. Averaging about 7 miles an hour on this ride because of all the weight I got. Plus these hills we got over here, you know. So, not doing bad.
Pretty wood color. Just passing Jefferson County High School. Pretty good size. Been working on it for a long time. All of a sudden, they just put this traffic light in. They used to have just a caution light, and it was, you felt like a squirrel crossing here. It's Highway 92 we're going to be crossing. Let's see if we can make it, maybe. This is Highway 92. I-40 would be down there to the right. Morris down up here to the left. I'm getting ready to go. Walnuts. Some walnut trees in my backyard. Car back. Another car back. That's a pretty day. That's pretty out there. Had many cars pass us today. It's the middle of the week. It's Wednesday. It's October the 1st. Wednesday. Calls off the day, so we're riding. My road.
Which will be a little while.
And we've been down that road before, so Paul said the next one. Make Fred feel happy. Right at home there. I think it's where he was on a hill one time photographing us coming up the hill. Well, that was his excuse. He was actually in the shade. Yep. And there stopped. Yep, told us how dangerous this is. Stopped in a church parking lot. We're gonna turn here. Yep, gotta have advice. Some folks.
That just makes me want to ride in the middle of the road even more.
Yeah.
I get assholes like that every day following me. I do the speed limit and they tailgate me.
Tom Breeden Road. There we go. down the road we go. Well, if you can't find the sign that is made for you, just put a couple together. Potter Road. Paul pointed it up here and he said, there's the hill we're going up. I'm really looking forward to this. These hills excite me. Paul and I here.
I still got to learn to pack a little lighter.
Paul's on a banana break. I've got my coffee here from this morning. Get back up here and see what that looks like. That is terrible. I had that orange bag. In fact, I didn't even have it. I just picked that up yesterday, as a matter of fact. It's a dry sack. And I had a dry sack. It was considerably smaller, but a heavier weight, which I didn't feel I needed. But that's has some sleeping, pretty much sleeping stuff in there.
Pick it up, eat it. Don't eat dirt.
Tent, pad, pillow, blanket, and the rest of my camera gear. Tripod. Paul has, I think I saw a kitchen sink in there, matter of fact.
Yeah. Everything but the
kitchen. He's got his full-size tire pump. When I saw those shoes, he showed me his, he's got a cooler back here.
Yeah, cooler. We got ice.
Paul.
We got hot dogs.
Look at those legs. You'd think he'd be doing something, but no.
We got sausage.
We've done 10 miles.
Yep.
We're out here in the country. We've had excellent roadside instructions on how dangerous this is.
Yeah. The guy, he stopped. He went past us in his big truck. And he stopped us. And he said, we're going to get killed out here. He said he wanted to know where we was going because we weren't going to make it.
Yep. Well, I don't know about him, but
he was sure of it.
We're having a good time today, and I guess that's all that's important. There's my chair, little rain jacket that I threw in that really you can use for a cover of any kind, cheapo rain jacket, hat, gear. I don't know which bag has which. I think it's all my food and stove, that sort of thing in here. I've got a toolkit down at the bottom, hope I don't need. And a pretty good size water supply. Clothes. And quite frankly, I forget what else in there. It's pretty much compartmentized, even though it's just a single bag. That's it. We're coffee time.
Here we go. Our break is over.
Break's over.
Maybe it's over. Definitely in the wrong gear there. Whoa! Yeah. I almost got run over by the car.
Fun whistle. It is.
Where's your fun whistle at? You lose it?
Speedy Gonzales.
action cam.
Hold on, Paul.
That's action cam.
Paul
just cranked up his little...
Turned on the GoPro.
Yeah, a little trailer toy
little,
there.
Little action cam.
I hear cars. I'm going to wait on the car, Paul. I'm bringing him around. You really have to work with the traffic. You have to let them know that you know they're there. Because that's the scariest thing when you're in cars, is not knowing what that cyclist is going to do. Dart out in front of you, go across the road. You have to remove that doubt. So. Anyway, here we go. A nice little area here. Catch Paul on the hills as long as he's pulling that trailer. Nice little downhill we just finished. Got a truck gonna meet us at this corner up here though.
I'm sorry, not left. We're gonna go right again. I'm sorry.
Pretty countryside. Come down. There's where we are. Somewhere on this road, I think this way. Appalachian Log Homes. I doubt Billy'd be seeing my videos, but one of these times I'll stop in and say hi. Corn doesn't look all that good this year, but Paul's up there playing with these walnuts in the road. Like a hand hockey. There's a nice long little downhill. You can see the roadway up there. Turned off Rocktown Road. Corals Road was nearby. About 25 miles an hour is with that much weight up that high on top of a large rear wheel, 700. Above 25 gets a little interesting. Eatery here.
That's where we're gonna eat at.
All right.
Lunch.
Here we go. Tolliver's Country Store.
Oh, it's Tolliver's.
Okay. Tolliver's.
Yeah. There's
Paul.
Bye.
finished a barbecue sandwich in the hill. And Paul just, I think he goes out and he looks for these hills. I'll just turn here. May Road. I hope he knows where he's going. Hey guys. Commerce Boulevard, I have no idea where we are. Are you lost yet?
Yep. That's that way.
Paul thinks we go left.
That way's flat though.
Paul thought we needed to turn left, but we turned right. So here we go. Airport. We just crossed the Andrew Johnson Highway of 11 E's, so we're getting close. Some nice houses looking on the lake. We're still about 2 miles, I think, from the park. Very busy road though, so I'm not gonna have a chance for much camera work. We just took a short. We just finished bombing a hill, and now we're going to have to pay for it. I'd say we're a heavy mile from the park.
Sign over there on film. Over there, see the sign? And I'll be back in a minute.
Well, we just checked in. No, I didn't take a picture of the osprey.
You know what?
I gotta take a picture.
Go ahead and give me one of them blue ones in there.
I'll take a picture of this.
Hey, look at these cups, dude.
I see. And
they're $8.
They're $10 too, right?
Or they're $8. No, they're. They're
glass.
They're
glass.
Oh wow. That'll break on the way home.
Nice. Nice guy. Got a beak like Paul.
Yeah.
Very pretty. The little bees are loving it.
Very nice little area here around the welcome center. There's restrooms in there. It's a beautiful day. There's our equipment. Boy. Left the welcome center. Oh, brother, what a nice looking hill. There's Paul way down there. I mean, way down there. I got a car behind me. I'm gonna slow down, bring the car around. I crash and burn. I don't want an audience. Very nice. We gotta be doing 25. About to miss it. That's good. You've probably heard how animals mark their spot. Paul's up here marking his tent spot. Hell, he may not even have a tent. This may be it. This may be Paul out for the night.
It.
Well, we've had
I get my hammock hanging up on the tree, we might just stay in that.
Pretty airy for sure. We're trying to mark our spot, but as far as we've gotten, has been the chairs, that's it. Paul's chair is on the ground. My chair is not on the ground. And I don't know what Paul's got. Paul's got a table or something. He's got, what does he have? Oh my goodness.
I'm a chair, man.
Do you see? I brought my own amusement.
Brought me with you. Here's some power.
There's a little bit of color over there in the next camping spot over. Not this color though. Paul's getting ready to kick back. Well, we're pretty much got the bulk of stuff unloaded. I even popped open the food bag. Got a screened up hammock here. Paul's got his two man kelpie. A little chair over here. Got a down pillow, real nice, comfy blanket, thermarest pad, an old one, and just a fleece
bag. There we are. This is the cat's meow. This could have been used to sleep in. Like Paul said, just put a pad in here and these little bungees up here, almost like a stretchy shock cord. Stretch a lightweight fly over that for rain protection, moisture protection, I should say. Paul, give it a try. We'll do an expert in and out.
I have to take my shoes off.
Well, yeah, take your shoes off. Well, you're gonna take your shoes off? Yeah.
Yeah, hold on.
He's doing it.
All right. Zip it up. This is nice.
Is that a nice one? Well, it's just like yours.
Yeah, I know.
You just don't have the...
Oh, you're ever ready.
I mean, that's really...
Keeps the bugs out. I love it.
Sweet. We've got the stink bugs up here real bad. They're about half dime size little discs that fly around. They're just annoying.
Yeah, a little bit. There you go.
Oh, that is just really nice.
And then you
could even
do one of these jobs when it's time to go to sleep.
Yeah, you could put little spreader bars up here if you wanted to. This is stretchy.
Yeah, those could go out a little bit further.
Yeah.
Something about that.
Well. Yeah.
They work okay.
Yeah. If a mat was in there.
Yeah, a mat would be all right. It would help it.
Yeah,
it
spread things out a little bit. That's the first time that.
I just like the part that it has a screen on it.
Yeah.
That right there is a plus.
That is nice. The grand trunk.
And yes, I could go.
I think I got it on sale from Climb, I believe. I don't remember the cost. $40, maybe $50. $50 at the most, I would imagine. Those are Paul's straps. Let's check them out. You got it? Real nice straps.
They're really good tree straps.
You got to have something on the trees. It'll protect that bark. And that looked like it did a pretty good job. I'd even like to see something wider than that. That's about a 1-inch strap. You see all the little loops that are real nicely sewn for different length selection. And that's a pretty good sized tree right there. That's a good 12 to 14 inch. So, we've got
that's a good log notching tree there.
Yep, and the other end, we're not even using all the strap. So that's super. There you have it. The Whipple cocoon. Well, Paul, we were going to put Paul's up over here, and the trees were just a little bit far apart. He could put his up over here. I kind of jumped on these trees first. That's the first time that hammock's been put
up. That's all right. So. I can sleep in your hammock tonight.
Well, see, you see how stupid I am? I hang the hammock and he sleeps in it.
He got a net on there. Look at that. Woohoo!
Yeah.
He's in there.
That's not to keep the bugs out. That's to keep me in.
The living dead.
Yeah. You got to have one of these if you're going to follow Paul around.
Yeah. Got to have a hammock.
This is a chill bag.
There's Ed coming out of the woods with his second batch of wood. Look at this guy. He's got it going on here.
Trail grooming.
Yeah, we're trail these grooming. I got a bunch too.
These are the straps that wouldn't really work well on the hammock.
Yeah, they wouldn't work on the hammock. So, look at that. He made a carrier for him.
We got it going on, guys.
Yeah, man.
Show them the pile we got.
Yeah, let's look at this pile over here we got. Oh yeah. All that right there, plus what he had. Right there. Yeah, I think we're set. I don't know, we might have to go one more time. That'll get us for a couple hours. We might have to go a little bit, one more time.
One more load, you know what that's gonna do?
That'd burn in like 2 seconds.
No, it's gonna make the shower.
Oh yeah, shower's gonna make really, it feel good. And we got it from over there, guys. Over there in the trees.
Here's what I was talking about.
And the mountains. We got them over there in the trees and the mountains. Yeah.
It's out there. It's primarily out there. The best stuff is the dry stuff that's snagged and hanging in the trees. Because
yeah.
It's dry and...
And you can't get to it. Yeah, that's the good one.
All right.
That's enough for tonight.
Yeah, it's shower 30.
You got that right. Shower 30, and that's another thing I didn't bring.
A towel. I bought a hand towel to shake a shower.
I guess I'll be drip drying.
We are so poorly organized. So
uncorganized.
We're
so uncorganized.
We're fired.
Yeah,
we're fired. I'm gonna wrap my shirt too. It's dirty.
Fired,
fired. I'm gonna tie this up in case we find something else to lasso.
Someone else to lasso.
There we go. There's our haul. We noticed a little fire. There's not any wind here tonight, so we don't have to have a big fire. We're so darn close to it anyway. Paul was bragging on these rooms a while ago. This shower, I haven't even been down here to the bathhouse yet, so. Let's see what's in here. Camera's gonna be a little bit shaky. Oh my, how nice, look at this. Look at this. This is all just a private room, wheelchair accessible. Fan. Heater. Electrical outlet for charging stuff. Door lock. Shower curtain. The price of the campsite was worth going to me. This nice warm shower.
You are pretty little kitties.
And even if dogs come, they're not afraid.
Nice
they feel secure.
Oh, how beautiful. Look at those eyes. Oh.
Rescues. Both of them are rescues.
That's good.
We never buy and we never buy animals.
Hey, sweetie.
I have my girl dog at home.
Hi, sweetie.
She's sitting right down there on the road. I know.
Just got out of the shower.
Three-lane traffic. Heading right towards three-lane traffic.
Aww.
She's been the best dog I've had. Out of all the dogs I've had, she's been the best. She's my little baby now. I'm just like,
hi, sweetie.
Oh, yeah.
Are you taking it with you when you travel?
I don't have it with me now.
Yeah.
Because we're riding bikes. We're on bicycles.
Sweetie.
Okay.
We pedaled bicycles here.
How far are you from home?
Dandridge. 20 miles.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm from Florida,
okay.
I wouldn't know.
Yeah.
That is precious. I'm glad I stopped you.
Thank you.
They are cute.
Yeah, they're boat rescues.
That's awesome.
That is just so cool. Here's the restroom facility from the other direction. And a little pavilion next door. And we're down the road there. Right up in there.
That's what I forgot to bring.
Well,
beans.
We're out here. Whoops.
I forgot to bring beans.
We're out here just having a good time.
Oh, yeah.
My vegetable soup. Paul's over there with
the hot dog going on.
Hot dog with his red light shining. I look like devil dogs.
Devil dogs. Yeah.
Get your red light up. Now I can't see.
Hold on a minute. Let me get a white light.
Yeah, you can't.
There you go. How's that?
Oh, yeah. Now
is that better?
Yeah, that's it. You got to show them your fork there, Paul.
Oh, yeah. There's my fork. Check it out. Huh?
God.
Yeah.
We're...
I'm Some hillbilly tonight. Yeah, baby.
Oh, man. Yeah, this is it.
TJ says, oh, that's awesome. That's sweet.
Alright, here we go. We got our fire going here, guys. That's a hottie. That's a good one.
Yeah, I left my coffee on the picnic table.
Oh, yeah. Fireflies, or my buddy Jeff, he likes them fireflies. There they are right
there. Remember I told you that?
There they are, Jeff. Fireflies. Look at that bad boy.
That's some pine in there popping.
Yeah. Yeah, we had some bark. One of our camp trips, we had some bark we put on there and it did the same thing. Mm-hmm. Fireflies.
Good ride, Paul.
There's a fire scene. No sense in zooming in on that, is there, Paul?
No.
I mean, that's it. This is the last of our wood, by the way.
That's the last of our wood.
And it is what time? What
One
time
o'clock.
Is it? Huh?
1 o'clock.
1 o'clock?
Pretty close.
Wow. Well, this is about firewood 30.
1 a.m.
1 a.m. Yeah. Paul had to...
It's Thursday morning.
Paul had to mention that. He's over there.
It's Thursday morning.
He's still on his little settee, doesn't have his long sleeve shirt. I'm sitting here with a flannel shirt on.
I'm still on my rocking chair.
Yeah. Well, we're about to expire, I think.
Yep.
We're getting close. So we'll see you in the morning.
After the fire goes out.
This is what I woke up to. Mm-hmm. And over here, coffee.
Max, mud.
Maxwell House, as a matter of fact. Oh yeah.
Mud.
It is. It's morning. I don't know if you want to see this group.
There's your other pieces right there.
Yep. We're here. I was pretty impressed with the attempt I made of lightening the load and going with some titanium silverware, but Paul upscaled me with his weight weenie version, and I'm impressed there, Paul. That's Paul's silverware right there. There's the evidence of how much wood we burned up last night, all but those two sticks. They were kind of flaming when we went to sleep. Well,
I really didn't want to leave them for somebody else.
Well, heaven forbid we leave firewood.
We should have burnt that wood.
Oh, God. We could have got up and had a little fire this morning, Paul.
We could have.
Okay. We're about there.
Next time.
Well, Paul's back here somewhere. See, that's how Paul does so well. He drafts you. He's using my air carts to make him faster. And we're still in the park, about to leave. We're not even a half mile from the entrance of the park. And Paul's dragging me up these hills. Look at this.
Drag me up the hill.
Wow. That's a fairly good example of how the trees are turning right there. Oh, what a nice hill. I'm going to drag the brakes as I still don't trust my load, but pretty country, for sure. Uh-oh. Got a gear down. Bye.
A little disaster.
It wasn't little, Paul. It was major.
Yeah, major disaster on the way back here from our trip.
Chain brake.
Yeah.
Right there. Chain brake. And the last thing I took out of my toolkit was a chain brake. I've got a master link. All I had to do is kick that out, put a master link in, and go back to town.
Yeah, but he don't have a tool, so.
I don't have the tool.
Left it at house?
Left the house.
That's light. Brilliant. He brought everything
light
but.
Lighten the load.
He brought everything but that. Lighten
so
the load.
So I can climb the hills.
Yeah.
Well, this is the hill down here.
This is the hill we were
coming
down.
Coming up, I said, let's downshift. So I had to downshift. I get up about where the trash can is. And.
Boom.
That was it. Pulled the tubes off. The
chain tubes came out.
One of them was just kind of loose anyway. So that's no big deal. I wanted to get them out of the way.
In the meantime, I called a tow truck. Tow truck's on its way. So we won't be finishing this ride.
Is it coming with a womb lift?
Yeah, it's coming with the womb lift. Yeah, okay. Womb lift, yeah. Yeah.
This was a different route, by the way.
Yeah, this was a different route. We were going home. We didn't come this way. But this is the way we should have came in the first place. There's only a couple big hill climbs, I think, here. And the rest was pretty much leveled out. Although, we're in Tennessee, there's always hill climbs. So here we sit, waiting for the tow truck. Well, Ed's inside of his contraption.
He doesn't know if
he's going to be able to get out of there.
It's like
or not.
A three-wheeled womb.
Yeah.
We have a fan club. This guy here is trying to steal our trikes a minute ago.
Well, not too many others in here with a fire going.
Yeah, they're all recuperating. They're all
old. So we're just getting the crank then.
Yeah, I like it.
Roll bar on his little pet peeve.